Hello, everybody. This is Dr. Carlos Ornello from White Coat Medicine Talks, partnering up with my buddy, Dr. David Cruz. And today I am going to be solo and talk to you specifically on anxiety. A lot of things to talk about anxiety. Why do we get anxious? What is the reason I have anxiety, and what can I do to help my anxiety? So I see a lot of patients that come in for anxiety, and so the first thing is try to focus on what your patients are saying about anxiety. Anxiety can be caused by so many things. So an excessive nervousness from simply taking an exam to just waking up nervous and sort of panicky is a type of anxiety. I'll try to focus on a few of those, but right now let's just talk in general. General anxiety. So people come in and feel their heart's palpitating. Sometimes they feel they can't breathe very well, but they're inside, they feel, you know, very anxious, very nervous. And a lot of times it could be that they're not sleeping. They have worries, which is part of life. They're not eating correctly. And they're not exercising. So we go through that with the patients to try to find the basis of a general anxiety. We'll definitely recommend that we do a physical, complete physical, just to make sure there's not anything that is related to anxiety, such as thyroid problems. You can have elevated blood pressure. So it's important that you tell your doctor all your symptoms and everything to do with why you're there that particular day. So going back to the anxiety, some of the things that we do besides the physical is the blood work, and also if everything turns out to be okay, there isn't a medical reason, we can start with sort of natural things and try to teach the patient to learn how to take care of themselves better, learn how to sleep better, and eat properly. Yes, food, eating the right type of food can help you control anxiety. Sugar has been one of the biggest culprits of causing anxiety. There's these energy drinks that you all are drinking out there that can affect you negatively, and besides, you know, giving you heart palpitations, they will definitely produce anxiety. So there's a lot of things that we try to do that are naturally, that are simple things to help you take care of something like anxiety. If it seems that it's a little bit more because it may be from a stressful situation, because you have other issues that require more treatment, and also more professional, seeking a therapist. Sometimes it's important to talk to about anxiety because they can give you the expertise of how to control your anxiety, and that's what they've been training for. But some of the medications that we have tried using, besides natural products, are anti-anxiety medicines like Xanax. Alprazolam is one of the most common. And we try to do that very frequently with a mild dose, so the person doesn't get used to taking it. And eventually, if she takes it or he takes it for a long time, you can get addicted. And that's the last thing we want you to be, is dependent on something like that. So those are some of the things that we would like to focus on. Other problems that are like anxiety are sort of panic attacks. This is something that has become a very common thing in our society, and people sometimes end up in the emergency room because they feel they're thinking they're having a heart attack. So they're having this acute nervousness, thoughts of uncontrollability, and it really and truly probably feels like they are having some other issues, and it's probably important that they get evaluated. But once they rule out any major problems such as a heart attack or hypertension, they come back and again we'll go through the whole routine we did with the general anxiety and try to focus on the food products that could stimulate anxiety. And again, we'll talk about with panic attacks. I've seen this with people that have ingested a lot of caffeine. Even caffeine products like that people like to take, especially like college students, to keep them awake. Lack of sleep, it will cause a lot of anxiety. So we'll get to the root of the problem and try to take care of that without having to use anxiolytics that will help them reduce their anxiety. And if this just becomes something very common, antidepressants seem to help with that because they have some anxiolytic effect as well. And sometimes, again, talking to your professional, your therapist, they have been trained for this, and talking about how to help you relieve some of these things. This is it for today, and hopefully we'll talk on other conditions next time. Thank you.